Hey, PC World fans, Adam here with Gordon. And we get a lot of questions on our weekly podcast, The Full Nerd, and you can send in your questions to thefullnerd@pcworld.com. A lot of times we get the same questions over and over and over again, so I wanted to take a moment and ask a PC expert one of these questions particularly. So Gordon, a lot of people are on older CPUs like the 2600K and they just want to know, is it still good for gaming? Are they doing okay? And if not, what's the CPU you would recommend they upgrade to?
Well, I generally, Ryzen 7 third gen is faster, ninth gen Intel is faster, all kinds of goodness, but if you're coming from a point where you've got a 2600K and you got a limited budget, we're going to assume limited budget, because yeah, if you can go out and buy a 3900X or 900K, hey, go do it, right? But if you don't got the budget to do that, I would say, if it were me, if it were a friend I was giving advice to, I would say just stick with it. You've got a fixed budget, you've got maybe $600, $700 you want to spend to get you more, right?
Yeah.
If you had a 2600K and all you had was $600 to do your new system, I would stick with a 2600K. It's not going to give you the highest frame rates. It's not going to give you the ability to stream at super high resolutions, but it will give you a really great gaming experience. And I would argue that $700 to $600 that you have to burn in buying a new CPU, a new motherboard, all the other goodness that you need, probably a new cooler too, because it's not going to fit if it doesn't come with it. Put that into a graphics card. Mm-hmm. If you are taking a 2600K with, say, 5-6 years ago, let's say you've got like a 970,
okay,
even a 980. Good card, good card.
Yeah.
But if you go from a 980 to a 2070 Super, a 5700 XT, you are just gonna be a lot, you're gonna get a lot more smiles than you are going from a 2600K to a 3700X or a 9900K, generally.
And that's just if you're gaming. If you mostly do gaming on your PC.
We're not saying,
or other light tasks.
Right, you're not gonna be video editing, you're not gonna be doing 3D animation, all that stuff. Let's face it, all you do is play games in this thing, you do Office, you do Chrome. New CPUs are great, they're faster, they do all kinds of great stuff. But you're going to get the most gaming joy out of a brand new, faster GPU in general. Hmm. Now, if you are going to say, hey, I want a 2600K, I want a 1080p panel at 240 hertz, 2600K is not going to do it as well as some other CPUs with the faster video card, too.
True.
But again, this sort of, that's your constraint is your budget. If you're talking about in a vacuum of just changing that CPU and not changing your GPU.
What if you have the money, you know, and you do other things than gaming and you want to step up?
Sure.
What's a good refresh for the 2600K situation?
So my thought is like, hey, you want to do it. You assume the GPU is out of the question. You've already upgraded that or you're going to upgrade it. What's a good CPU to go for? I'm going to assume because you have a 2600K vintage at this point, 2012-ish range, right? So, you know, pretty old. You spend about $329 because that's what Intel's top end, kind of like consumer CPU used to go for. In that $330 range, I would say definitely go for a 3700X. If you want to save some money, actually you can save a lot of money, go for a 3600. You'll be pretty happy with gaming as well. Ryzen just gives you all kinds of really good performance and a hell of a lot more cores than you're getting out of Intel for multi-thread performance. If you're squeamish and you do like Intel because, oh, I only trust Intel, whatever, then, 9700K moves you up to 360 and you gotta buy the cooler, but good choices still. If you're gonna do Intel, clearly the better value and performance. Better performance, because sometimes people hear better value, they think, oh, there's a compromise in performance. There's no compromise in AMD with performance. I'm gonna say generally. So I would say Ryzen first, but if you like Intel, 9700K. But generally, 2600K, you don't have to move. If you've only got $500 to do an upgrade and you've got like a 9 series card, I would disagree with any of you to say buy a CPU and stick with that 9 series GPU. I would say go to something brand new.
Or maybe instead, switch to an SSD if you can.
If you don't have an SSD, yeah. SSD is a better option. But you do have to, I'm saying this, 2600K is a great part, but it's PCIe 2. The USB sucks. There's no NVMe M.2 slot on that. You're not going to be able to do that easily. You're not going to be able to boot to it. There's just so many things that are holding that platform back. It's basically a Honda Civic with 350,000 miles on it, right?
Yeah, right.
So if you want to upgrade, you go to a brand new system with a grand, it'll feel awesome. But you know, there's some compromise you're going to get with that. And the other really big issue that you might want to go, oh, it's time to dump this, is, if you bought a Dell or an HP or a Lenovo, you probably got a lot of security updates to support all the Spectre meltdown stuff.
Yep.
A lot of these board vendors are like, hey, good luck. You should have bought, just go out and buy something new. We're only going to support Skylake and on. A lot of them are dumping you overboard. If you got Haswell, you're going overboard. Sandy Bridge, definitely going overboard. So if you are afraid of a security threats from those, it doesn't look like anybody's using it. But if you're just sort of a security cat about security, then it might be a good idea to move on to a new CPU.
Okay, I love hearing your take on this. And I want to hear your take on it. Chime in the comments below. And like I said, if you have questions, email them to thefullnerd@pcworld.com. If we don't answer them on the stream, we might take some of them and answer them here in this kind of format. So thanks for taking the time to answer questions, Gordon. Thank you.